Now, this is a question which has plagued the 2021 season pretty much since it began. If you are in Camp Max Verstappen, you'll be proclaiming that he drove a shitbox of a car to claim the world title, whereas if you were in Camp Lewis Hamilton, you'd be proclaiming that he drove a shitbox of a car to title contention. And if you fit yourself anywhere between Camp Max Verstappen and Camp Lewis Hamilton, you'll say that they were pretty much even, but some races favoured other teams. But in this video, we're going to take a look at who really had the fastest car between Mercedes and Red Bull. Now, this is going to be split into two parts, and part number one will look at qualifying. So let's pull up the first half of the season, the first 11 rounds up to Hungary. We're taking a look at Lewis Hamilton, Valtteri Bottas, Max Verstappen, and Sergio Perez, and on screen are each of their respective fastest qualifying times for the first 11 rounds. Note the asterisk by Perez's Bahrain lap time, that was set in Q2 and not in Q3. And the colours denote which was the fastest time. The sort of orangey gold is the fastest, the silver is the second fastest, the deep orange is the third fastest, and then no colour is the fourth fastest. And totalling up each of these first, seconds, thirds, and fourths, we end up with Hamilton and Verstappen being even at 5, 3, and 3 respectively, and then Valtteri Bottas being a little bit better than Sergio Perez. But totalling up the times that Mercedes was faster than Red Bull, it was 6-5 in the former's favour. But moving into the second half of the season, and again pulling up the lap times for each of the drivers, with Belgium and Russia being highlighted with an asterisk because they were rain-affected sessions, and Perez having a double asterisk in the Netherlands because he was out in Q1. We can see by totalling up the first, seconds, thirds, and fourths again that it was Hamilton who had a slightly better qualifying performance in the second half of the year. Now, bear in mind for the events which held a sprint race, so Britain, Italy, and also Brazil, these times are taken from the Friday qualifying format of Q1, 2, and 3. And we can see that the times ahead for Mercedes and Red Bull was actually 7-4, so a significant advantage to Mercedes. But now what we need to do is a lap time analysis of all of this data. If we take the fastest lap time of each team, regardless of who set it, and calculate the percentage difference between those two times, we can work out the advantage each team had at each of the 22 rounds of this year. Where we can see that in Portugal, Mercedes had a 0.51% advantage in qualifying over Red Bull, where 0.51% in qualifying roughly equates to half a second across the long circuits like Spa and Azerbaijan, close to 100 seconds, and it's roughly 4 and a bit tenths, maybe 4.2 tenths, over the shorter circuits like Austria and Monaco. But if we were to average every single one of these percentages on screen, we would end up with an advantage to Mercedes of 0.14% per qualifying lap. But then if we were to average all of the times that Mercedes were ahead, and then when Red Bull were ahead separately, we would see that there is actually a significant difference between the two teams. However, if we exclude the two rain-affected qualifying sessions of Belgium and Russia, this actually decreases Mercedes' advantage to just 0.1%, and it slashes their advantage when ahead to 0.36%. Equally, for those people interested, we can total up all of the times that the drivers had a first, second, third, or fourth fastest time across these four drivers, and we can see that Hamilton was the faster qualifier than Max Verstappen only just, but Valtteri Bottas was significantly faster than Sergio Perez in qualifying. So Bottas was the better wingman to Lewis Hamilton than Sergio Perez was to Max Verstappen in qualifying. So looking at all of the data from the qualifying sessions of this year, we can determine that in qualifying, Mercedes did have the fastest car. However, the story takes a little bit of a turn when we look at the races. Now, in order to explain how I've extracted the data from the races, let's pull up the lap times for Bahrain 2021 for Hamilton, Bottas, Verstappen, and Perez. And we're going to look first at Lewis Hamilton. We're going to highlight any safety car periods, lap number one, any pit stops, any VSCs, any random slow laps at all. And then we are going to transpose these laps onto the three remaining drivers, regardless of if that driver set a slow lap on that particular lap. Then we will look at Valtteri Bottas and highlight his slow laps or his pit stops or any periods of time that he's in the virtual safety car slash safety car period, and once again transpose those laps onto the three remaining drivers. Rinse and repeat this process for Max Verstappen, transposing them onto the other drivers, and again finally for Sergio Perez, once again transposing them to the other drivers. We end up removing around 20 to 30% of the overall laps, and then what is left gets averaged. So taking a look at the first half of the season, we can see it looks a little like this. Note the DNFs have been noted, although in Azerbaijan, even though Verstappen did have a DNF, he did a significant portion of the race where his average was not affected. Exactly the same colour scheme does apply to the qualifying format that we have just looked at, and totalling up the first, seconds, thirds and fourths overall, we can see that it was Verstappen who had a significantly better race pace advantage than Lewis Hamilton, and then for the two teammates, it was Perez who was ever so slightly better than Valtteri Bottas. But looking at Mercedes versus Red Bull, it was actually 7-4 in the latter's favour. Which is actually supported by the fact that Verstappen was able to pull a 31-point gap to Lewis Hamilton by the end of Austria. However, the story turns when we take a look at the second half of the season. Note that Belgium, Russia, and Turkey all have asterisks by them because they were rain-affected races. So again, totalling up the first, seconds, thirds, and fourths overall, we can see that it was Hamilton who had a better race pace in the second half of the year compared to Max Verstappen, who interestingly had joint the amount of firsts that Sergio Perez had, with Valtteri Bottas this time actually popping up at the bottom of the pile. And if we total up the times that Mercedes was ahead of Red Bull, it was actually 6-4 compared to 7-4 for Red Bull in the first half of the season. Then once again, exactly like we did for qualifying, taking each team's fastest lap time regardless of which driver set it and calculating the percentage difference of those two lap times, we can see a significant advantage for Mercedes in both Britain and in Hungary. But again, averaging out all of these percentages regardless of the asterisk, we can see it's a 0.06% advantage in favour of Mercedes. Now bear in mind, 0.06% is pretty much nothing. This is 0.06 of a second per racing lap at the long circuits of Spa and Azerbaijan, and closer to 0.04 at the shorter circuits of Monaco and Austria, which over the course of an hour-long race roughly equates to about 6 seconds. That's really not a lot of race time at all. So if we go ahead and take a look at the times when Mercedes was fastest and when Red Bull was fastest independently, we can see that there is actually a significant pace difference. Mercedes is 0.53% quicker when in front, and Red Bull is 0.36% faster when in front. However, excluding the outliers of Hungary and also Imola, this slashes the advantage of Mercedes to overall 0.01% per lap, and 0.42% when they were in front. However, there is one more outlier on that screen, which is Britain. This is comparing Lewis Hamilton to Sergio Perez as Max Verstappen retired on lap number one. And we are comparing the second fastest Red Bull driver to the fastest Mercedes driver, hence why the difference is actually more abnormal than the rain-affected Hungary session when both Red Bulls were significantly damaged. So if we exclude the outlier of Britain, it actually turns to a Red Bull advantage of 0.08% per racing lap, and an advantage to Mercedes when they were in front of just 0.29%, lower than the 0.37% of Red Bull. And then totalling up each of the drivers' first, seconds, thirds, and fourths overall, Hamilton and Verstappen were pretty much even, but Verstappen was a little bit better as he had more second places, and Sergio Perez was better than Valtteri Bottas. So Sergio Perez in the races was a better wingman to Max Verstappen than Valtteri Bottas was to Lewis Hamilton. So we can see that from all of this data that the races, both teams were pretty much even. There was really nothing to choose between Mercedes and Red Bull. Whereas in the qualifying, there was definitely a difference. Mercedes definitely had an advantage, albeit small, in qualifying. But in the races, whichever way you spun it, another team comes out on top, and it is by the slimmest of margins. 0.01% is literally a second over an hour. It's absolutely nothing. Now, obviously, you can take this video however you like. That is the whole point of these. You can just take the data and throw it wherever you like in arguments for or against who had the fastest car. But please remember, don't be an ass on social media. Remember that it's other human beings on the other ends of whichever device you're communicating on. And just remember to keep it civil. But that is all I've got for you today, guys. I hope you have enjoyed. And please let me know of anything that you found interesting in the comments down below. But I will catch you in the next video with whatever and whenever I decide to make it. I'll see you guys then.